Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to yet another amazing episode of Cote's Cube. It's amazing because Nathan Fletcher's here. How are you, brother?
Great. And yourself?
I'm doing very well. Thank you very much. Let's talk North Shore. How long have you been over here?
Probably like a month.
A month? And where do you stay over here?
At the moment, I stay by Waimea at Eo's house.
Okay. Tell me about the, so far, what's the vibe?
Everything's been great. It was good pipe right at first, and then it's been pretty much flat. So it's been about 2 weeks, just kind of smaller waves.
Just like preparing, getting ready.
Yeah, but there was an initial little burst, and then preparing, I ended up hurting my shoulder a little bit, so I'm out for the next couple days, and then something's gonna happen.
Yeah. Are you so when you go down there, you watch the Pipe Masters and all that stuff. Do you like try to help some of your friends like get through heats? Obviously you surf pipe enough to know like where to sit and all that.
No, because actually anybody that's out there is pretty much experienced enough to know what they're doing. But I pretty much go down there just to see what's going on, with the kids and with the older guys and whatever, the top 44 and that. People who really rip.
Yeah. A lot of people, don't know this, but you're like a surf fan. You're a fan of surfing, right?
Yeah. I just love it. So, if that's a fan, yeah.
Hell yeah. Well, you were lucky enough to be on this trip with Bruce down to Mexico. Sick waves down there. Bruce is very complimentary, saying how, you got him psyched to go surfing. How do you stay psyched?
Well, I quit surfing for a while when I was like probably like 15 or so till 20, or maybe 16 to 21. And after working and having to work for my dad and pack boxes and ship boxes, and then just being able to go surf after that Tahiti contest and all of a sudden be a pro surfer and get a little bit of money, and then I just look at it as every day. It's like, so lucky. And I don't know, just try and be stoked, because it's all you got to do is surf and stay stoked. And it's like, for that, it's just, I couldn't make the time last long enough. I think it's like, this is a dream for a moment.
Hell yeah. Well, no, last year we were just talking about like, you had that gnarly leg break. So obviously that's another reason why every day when you get up and you walk to the beach, you're just like, you want to pal out, get barreled.
Yeah, every day it even gets more, because it's like, I guess that'd be closer you get to the end of being able to surf. And so it's like, I guess as you get older, you just appreciate it.
What about movie projects? Your last movie came out like, was 2 years ago?
Yeah, probably. Probably three by the time you actually think
right
about
now,
it.
Yeah. you got other stuff in the works that we really would like to see some more Nathan Fletcher footage.
Yeah, actually, something's in the works. I just don't know what yet, but I've definitely been trying to figure out what's going on and where I want to be, because whatever's coming next is going to be pretty much, something that I want to do forever. And I know something to do with photography or film or making something of, I think maybe more artistic or creative and not action. I don't know. We'll see what happens if yeah. I do it or if it's sponsored or what.
Hell yeah. Well, whatever you do, we're going to be fans of. Nathan, thank you for coming on the Cube. Hopefully, maybe later today or tomorrow, we're going to be sitting down there watching you get barreled at Pipeline.
Yeah, I'd hope and love that too.
Hell yeah. Whoa. Good catch, brother.